Fiona, I'm just going to the convenience store to pick some stuff up for dinner, okay? All right, I hope they're open.
Hey, Dad.
Let me out. You freak me out.
You should try calling them first. Most places are closed on Christmas Eve.
Well, I'm aware of that.
So you should call them. It'll save you time.
Look, I'm not actually going to the convenience store. I'm actually picking up a gift for your mother. I pre-ordered the new PlayStation 15 for her.
Mom plays video games?
She used to. I didn't allow video games inside the house because I was worried they'd have a bad effect on you and your sister. Now she says she's depressed and that I'm the worst husband ever.
You do know that we have an Xbox at home, right?
You have an Xbox?
Yeah, I bought it a while back. I thought you knew. You had a rule that I couldn't talk to strangers online. It's how I play Fortnite with Helios and Tahu.
Lemuel, you can't expect me to remember everything about you. Anyway, this new PlayStation 15 will be her console.
Do you think she'll play Fortnite with us?
Maybe?
Oh, BTW, have you found my sister yet?
No, not yet. The Light Warriors aren't returning my emails.
You should try calling them, it'll save you time.
Shut up.
My dad is so funny. Well, I got my own things to do. You'll see. Come on, let's go! My first stop is Pik-pik's house.
What in the world?
I knew Pik-pik likes to go crazy with her decorations, but this is a little bit wacky.
Are you actual people or are you statues?
Some of us are statues. Myself, I'm a person.
Well, but why are you doing this for Pik-pik?
She's paying us a lot of money, so.
How much are you getting paid?
Like 20 bucks an hour.
That doesn't seem like a lot of money for the job.
Well, I don't have a job otherwise. Life sucks.
Oh, look at that!
Pik-pik!
It's Edge and Blossom! And Pik-pik!
What?!
Pik-pik, yeah, can I borrow your Pikmin tree?
Huh?! I'm sorry?!
Don't worry, yeah, I can get you a new one by tonight.
If you can get a new one, why don't you just get a new one yourself? Why do you need mine?
Well, you see, I temporarily traded my tree for a tree with from a guy who wanted one that was blue. And since my tree was blue, I wanted to give him the blue tree. But unfortunately, the guy mixed up my house with the raccoon's house, and he accidentally stole a raccoon's tree, which then was apprehended by the police, and now the tree belongs, to the police, and I've promised to give the raccoon a tree, but I don't have a tree, mine's blue, so he wants a normal tree.
Shut up! Fine, take my tree!
Yeah, yes! Come on, Blossom.
Hey, Edge. Hey, Blossom. Hey, Auntie.
What is it?
I'm delivering gifts to everyone.
Oh, a present?
Yeah, there's one for you and Tiffany in here. Hold on. Here you go. Don't fall over! I have presents for you, Blossom, Cole, and Belle.
Yeah, that's epic, let me out, yeah.
Well, it's too bad that Sunny, Thorn, and Helios went to Space Hawaii. I wanted to have a proper dinner party at their place again this year.
Yeah, and Abel and Darkness went to Mars last week. I haven't heard from them since.
Yeah, my parents wanted to hunker down by themselves anyway. I don't even think they even want me involved in their little holiday fun.
So, what are you gonna do for Christmas Eve?
I have a date.
With your girlfriend?
Yeah, well, we've never really defined our relationship. It's always kinda, I don't know. But today's gonna be different. I'm changing everything. I'm gonna be bold. I'm gonna be a true romantic.
Whoa. So, what do you have planned to do with her, y'all?
No idea. I'm completely winging it. I'm self-motivating myself into a pit. All right, wish me luck.
Yeah, good luck, young soldier, yeah.
See ya!
Let me out.
I'm here, right on time.
We haven't seen each other in a while. What have you been up to since you graduated?
Helping my dad around the house and going on space adventures. I'm looking for a stable job on the colony. I want to try the hunting guild.
The hunting guild is dangerous.
Well, I'm a dangerous guy. What are you going to do now that you've graduated?
I haven't figured it out yet.
You're a real academic. You could get a doctorate in something. You should go to a university on Earth. They're accepting robotic toys as students now.
Maybe. I've never been off the colony before.
Never?
I've always wanted to see the other planets. You always talked about them.
I could take you.
That would be nice to do someday.
Well, we could go right now.
Right now? I haven't prepared.
You don't need to prepare anything. We could tour the whole solar system within a couple hours.
But we were gonna hang out.
We are hanging out. Come on, let's go. Ah. Look, we're gonna take that X-Wing.
You never told me you were a pilot.
Well, I haven't needed to pilot anything in years.
Will we even fit in there together?
I'm pretty small.
Have you even flown this type of ship before?
Once you've learned to pilot one ship, it's easy to manage any ship. It's like driving a car.
You have a driver's license too?
No, actually.
Is this ship airtight? It's made out of Lego.
It's just a novelty design. It could operate in space just fine.
Is this even your ship?
No.
Please, don't go too fast.
If I go slow, it'll take us weeks. Space is pretty big, you know.
Ooh, Jupiter looks so pretty.
Looks a lot different up here than compared to on the colony.
Are they all this pretty?
The planets? Oh, of course. Which one do you want to see first? Mars? Pluto?
Earth.
The boring one?
I've never been.
Oh, right.
These are real humans? They're giant!
Kinda stressful being around them, isn't it? Once long ago, there was a human civilization on Mars, run by the angel known as the Princess of Mars. Her kingdom eventually became the myth of Amazon warriors.
Was it all women?
I don't think it would have been able to survive if it was.
Says the man.
Hey, I'm a Pikmin!
Venus is so pretty!
Very dangerous. We probably shouldn't land there. Our ship might catch fire. The crater right below us is from a battle between my father and a BGM.
Background music?
No, Babylonian God Machine.
What's the story with Mercury?
No one ever lived there. It was named after the Roman god Mercury, which is the same as the Greek god Hermes. I don't know too much about Hermes, except I think the angels got pissed at him and they tried to kill him. But his character became kind of mythical. You remember last year when Darkness put on that play about the first Christmas?
How could I forget?
The baby from the play was trying to spread some truth to the humans, kind of like Hermes. But regardless, the truth still lives on, and change still happens. I mean, otherwise we wouldn't be celebrating Christmas.
This one is so blue, is this Neptune?
Yeah. Fun fact, they believe it rains diamonds on Neptune.
It rains diamonds?
Well, we've never proven it. You can't really get close to this planet without being completely destroyed by the storms.
Getting a diamond from an alien world would be so romantic.
And this is Pluto. It's very cold.
Why is space so cold?
Do you need a blanket?
You're warm. Cuddle me.
I can't really pilot if I'm... Saturn was the Roman god that we consider equivalent to the Greek god Kronos. It was associated with the changing seasons, harvest, and time. Though, the angels actually associate time to the planet Pluto, so we're not exactly sure where the human version came from.
You're pretty knowledgeable on this stuff.
Balatron taught me most of it.
Lemiel, you're so cool.
Thanks.
Like, really, really cool.
You're very cool, too.
Your transformation is cool, too.
Well, that's my angel form.
Can you show me?
You've seen him before at the track meets.
But I'd never talk to you in that form.
That's because he doesn't really want to talk to you. It's complicated.
Is it like a split personality?
Actually, that's exactly what it is. And he doesn't like women.
Oh, bother. Well, maybe if I had a chat with him, he'd start loving them.
Don't hold your breath.
What makes him so uptight?
Well, he fought in two wars, witnessed his mother commit suicide, and was the last person living in the universe. He suffered a trillion years of loneliness until the final star burnt out.
Oh.
Then I woke up, and I saw Balatron. And he brought you back. He brought everyone back. To try one more time. He called it New Game Plus. Oh, this is our last stop.
And this is your anus, right?
You're supposed to pronounce it Uranus.
But it's funnier when you say it the other way.
Normally, I would love your sense of humor, Sakura, but Uranus is sacred.
Oh, sorry. What makes it so sacred?
In antiquity, it was used as the main gateway between heaven and earth. The portal's been changed to restrict access, so I can't really take you inside.
What? You mean heaven is inside Uranus?
No, it's a portal. It's not actually inside Uranus.
How could heaven be inside Uranus?
Well, again, it's not actually inside. It's just a portal.
So you've been inside?
Yes, I've been there a couple times. Actually, the whole universe went in there during the Starlight War, so you were there.
I don't remember that.
I think everyone's forgetting life before the reset.
What is it like in there?
Well, it's not paradise, I can tell you that. Paradise is something different. The world beyond Uranus is a devastated land. Humanity once talked of an ancient civilization known as Atlantis. That's just one of the many names for this realm. It's also called Elysium, Arca, Babylon. The ones that call themselves gods promised humanity that they'd be permitted into this heaven if they proved to be holy servants. This adapted into the mythic nature of heaven as it is described today.
So what's paradise?
The true endpoint of all living souls. Balatron promised me, well, he promised us all, that this time we will reach paradise. New Game Plus is our final attempt.
What's happening?
Attack!
Attack!
Hold on! What are they?
Ah!
They're fast! I need to get behind one!
Take this!
This crummy ship can't penetrate their armor! They're separating!
Are we gonna die?
Calm down, we're gonna be fine!
Let me out. Let me out. If we die out here, I want to make sure you know before we die, I've always loved you.
Never distract a pilot during a dogfight!
You caught one!
We're not dying out here. And, I mean, come on, Sakura. I already knew you that you loved me.
You did not. You're just trying to act cool.
I'm acting cool?
Yeah, you're being all I know instead of just saying it back like you should.
What if I didn't actually mean it back?
You wouldn't have taken me on this romantic date if you didn't.
I didn't exactly want to say it during combat.
What if we die before you get a chance to say it?
We're not gonna die. Something is blowing them up!
What is that?
All the targets are gone. It wiped them all out.
So, are you gonna say it or not?
Oh, right.
You're unbelievable.
How about this? I'll only tell you if you marry me.
You...